12,167. Today I'm going to talk about new lecture which I already started to write. Yesterday I wrote an introduction to that lecture, and it was all about it was all about some dramatical appearance. I just wrote a little bit about myself. The first question was how to introduce myself second time, because I don't like to say, oh, hello, my name is this, and it's really, because if it's a second course and second lecture in the course, in the first lecture I already introduced myself, and this time I have to talk something different, and I was thinking how to start, and I decided to start from questions to question people whether how many of them were on my first lecture, how many of them watched the lecture on the internet. Then I ask how many people started working and applying, what they learned from that lecture. Then I go and then I introduce myself. I just say, for those who are seeing me the first time, my name is Vladimir. Now I'm going to and I am working on thinking. I am working on thinking. And then I go and then I talk a little bit about philosophy and connect my work with the science which was called philosophy in times back. So then I just I can't talk about it in English. I was writing it in Russian. Now I'm trying to translate in my head everything from Russian to English, and it's not a good idea. So I just started writing it. I wrote an introduction, and the whole lecture will develop to the idea that you can improve your thinking through focusing on developing your attention, your memory, your attention, and your imagination. And all these things connected with, for example, memory, it's all about past, mostly, it's not all, it's mostly about the past. So when you want to improve your memory, you just focus on the past and learn something from past, let's say. You just remember your experience and you work on your experience rather than memorizing words. You're trying to remember all important things which happened to you in your past, and you learn how to talk about these things. You try to connect them in a story, so that you can improve this story again and again and again. You can take this story of yourself, you can find 5, 6, 10, 15 events which happened in your life, and you just connect these events, and you think about it, and you write what you thought about the past, and that's how you focus on improving your memory. You're working with your memory and trying to remember everything clearly. So attention, basically, it's when you focus on something right now. For example, it can help you to improve your thinking. You can watch something, you can read something, you can train your attention by focusing on something that goes on right now. And also you can focus on your thinking and learn to vocalize everything what's going on in your head. Because most of the time you are silent, and while you are silent, there's still the process. Because at any time, if you